What's going on, everybody? It's your boy C4 today, bringing the newest episode of the legendary college roster videos. And for the love of God, hopefully we have a fucking winner here. We have struggled immensely trying to string together a couple wins in any of these. I think we made the playoffs in the very first debut episode, which was the Wisconsin Badgers. But since then, it has not been very good. So today we're working our way. First of all, we gotta do the intro, C4. Come on, one step at a time. We're doing the top 25 ranked college football teams, according to, I think it was collegefootballnews.com. Definitely sounds like a legit website. And we're on today, number 19, which is the Arkansas Razorbacks. And, you know, just ignore the fact that as a Canadian that was never born into America, doesn't understand your culture, why Arkansas is not Arkansas, you know. That's another point for another day, because it's spelled the exact same way as the state of Kansas. But, what we're going to do here is we're going to sim the moments. We're going to play, or actually sim to week 16, because week 16 and week 17 are divisional matchups. And hopefully, for the love of God, we're in the playoff hunt, and then we can get gameplay of those two last games, plus whatever happens in the playoffs. That has been the plan. But, it hasn't gone according to plan, as we've only made the playoffs once, I think. We not even made the playoffs with the Wisconsin one. I can't remember. It was so long ago. So there have been some tweaks. We know we've been growing. There's been growing pains as we've gone through these series. I think we have, you know, definitely the best formula here, where I've juiced everyone. Before, I was just juicing guys, juicing. Don't think it as, like, I know it is a sexual term in some parts, but more so just giving guys really crazy overalls in regards to just everything. And some guys were being low. Like, I'd say the average overall, we're playing against, too, I should state, the legendary rosters that we did in the legendary roster video around Christmas time that you guys liked. So, I mean, every roster is fucking really, really overpowered. So what we're doing now, what we haven't always done in the series, we're making everyone's rating what they would have been if this was, say, an NCAA game. So most of the time, players would be in the high 90s that end up getting drafted in the NFL and having successful careers in the NFL. But that's enough talking. You guys seem to get the gist of it. Let's take a look here at the Arkansas Razorback roster. And what I'm doing is I'm using Atlanta Falcons. It's just a red jersey. Looks pretty similar. So at quarterback, we're going Ryan Mallett, 89 overall. I tried to find Brandon Allen. Brandon Allen, famous from our Toronto Huskies connected franchise mode, but I must have edited over him in the original legendary roster series. So Ryan Mallett was the only Arkansas quarterback that I could find. We only need one quarterback. I think he's probably the most talented Arkansas quarterback of the last, maybe of all time. I remember he had one of the biggest arms in college football history. So that's why you can see the 99 throw power way over here. So he will be our quarterback going forward. At the running back position, we have Darren McFadden and Nile Davis. Nile Davis, we gave him an 88. Darren McFadden, I remember that was right when I first started getting into college football. It was McFadden. I think Peyton Hillis was the backfield there. I think Peyton Hillis was like the fullback running back hybrid, whereas Darren McFadden was a running back, almost quarterback hybrid, threw the ball there a little bit. So he will be our starting running back. Fullback, we just kept whoever was on the fucking, the Falcons, Patrick DeMarco. Then at wide receiver, we have Lance Allsworth. It's definitely Allsworth. There's no S there, you fucking idiot. Legendary San Diego. Legendary Los Angeles Charger. Oh, my God. I feel for you guys on that one. But 97 overall. Definitely a big-time playmaker. We have 90 overall Jarius Wright, who is on the Minnesota Vikings. And then we have 87 overall guy found on free agents, Javonte Herndon. Never heard of this guy in my life, but Wright has had some solid playmaking games that I've seen. A couple game-breaking runs after the catch for the Minnesota Vikings, and Allsworth was well before I started playing. But Lance Allsworth is probably the best wide receiver in the history of Arkansas Razorbacks. At tight end, we're going with Hunter Henry, another San Diego, Los Angeles Charger. He looked really good in his rookie season, and it looks like they will be, in good hands once Antonio Gates decides to hang his cleats up. So we gave him a 94 overall. Left tackle, we gave Jason Peters 95. Jason Peters did play tight end at Arkansas. A little known fact that I'm pretty sure a lot of Eagle fans know. But if you're not an Eagle fan, you may not know. Jason Peters, who in my honest opinion, as it stands right now, is the only Hall of Famer on the Eagles roster right now. And I definitely think he should be a Hall of Famer. It's all said and done, considering the position change. Yeah, he started out as tight end, and he went undrafted, and then the Buffalo Bills picked him up, made him a tackle. He was like just becoming a freak at left tackle, and then the Eagles traded for him from the Buffalo Bills, and it's been absolute awesomeness ever since. Left guard, we have Alvin Bailey, who we gave a 95 overall. He's currently a member of the Cleveland Browns. At center, we have Travis Swanson, 94 overall, who's a member of the Detroit Lions. But I remember when he was coming out, I actually think that's starting to date myself. Well, not a little bit. He's only been in the league for a couple years. I remember I had him as the top interior offensive lineman one year, the top center of the draft class. I don't know how well he's doing for you guys down there in Detroit, but I think he was number two on the depth chart, according to Madden's terms. But hopefully he can get it around and be a solid starter for you guys. At right guard, we have Sebastian Tretola from Arkansas, who's just a rookie. He was regarded as one of the sleeper interior offensive linemen in this year's coming draft class, or last year would have been last year's draft class. So we gave him a 91. And then at right tackle, we have Mr. Insanity himself, Sean Andrews, 93 overall. He was a left tackle for the Philadelphia Eagles. This guy here was, you know, I think, okay, basically, if you don't know what happened, let's take a little bit because it's an Eagles story. Sean Andrews came into the league as a rookie. I don't know if it was his rookie year or every year after that. He was an All-Pro. All-Pro, Pro Bowl, looking straight up like Joe Thomas. Looked like his career was starting out. If he would have been able to maintain everything, he probably would have been the Eagles' Joe Thomas. We might not have ever had Jason Peters because of that, or maybe we'd move him to tackle or something. But Sean Andrews was looking like the next great offensive lineman. Then he fucked up his back some way, and then he became like, I don't know what, you know, what you call people that they think they're sick all the time. It was like a mental thing. Every time he started to play football again after he hurt his back once, he thought he was going to fucking hurt his back again. And he tried to make a comeback. I think he was on the Giants for a bit. But that was the biggest thing. It was a mental issue. And it sucks, man, because he could have been the next great, you know, offensive lineman in the NFL. And it was cut short. But he is going to be included. We'll show him some love here, even though he never had sick-ass dreads like that. Defense side of the ball, left defensive end, we have Trey Flowers. Who, that's not actually Trey Flowers. I think I must edit over him because he's currently looking like he's an emerging playmaker on the New England Patriots defensive line. So we gave him a 97 overall. Right defensive end, we have Billy Ray Smith Jr., who I have some Wikipedia pages up on guys. I have no idea. He was selected number 5 overall in 1983 and played for the Los Angeles Chargers. What the fuck? Chargers just like getting Southern boys from fucking Arkansas. He was a second-team All-Pro in 1989. San Diego Chargers 50th anniversary team. Two-time All-American in college. And is a member of the College Football Hall of Fame. Defensive tackle, we have Dan Hampton, who was a big, big integral part of that very good Chicago Bears defense in the 80s. And then we also have this guy named Henry Ford. No, not the guy that invented the car. But he was a defensive tackle who got selected first round, 26 overall, by the Houston, Tennessee Oilers. And that was pretty much it because you're a first round pick. We'll include you on our rosters. Left side linebacker, we have Tony Bua, 91 overall. Don't really remember a whole lot about him, but I do know he is a famous hit that he had on the Miami Dolphins. So we best believe we added him to get some just crazy hits. I can't remember what the I don't know. Just find it on YouTube. It was a just absolutely disgusting hit. He was a big-time hitter. Borderline dirty player, but a big-time hitter. Middle linebacker, we have Jerry Franklin. Not super familiar with him. I found him on free agency, and I was like, all right, we'll just throw him in here because I can't find any middle linebackers. And something someone suggested, great, great suggestion, but some of these teams aren't even good right now. Someone said where I can't find, legends, if you will, just take the best player currently on that college roster. I think that's a great idea. But looking at Arkansas' defense, not a whole lot of people there right now. So we went with Jerry Franklin. And then a right outside linebacker, we went with Rodney Caveness. Again, another guy, who the fuck is that, really? But he was a ninth-round pick in the NFL, a second-round pick in the AFL, played for the Chiefs and Oilers, but most importantly, is a member of the College Football Hall of Fame. So if you're a member of the College Football Hall of Fame in 2010, I think he was inducted, you're going to be a member of our roster. Looking at the secondary, this is where the corners especially, are an area that it was kind of tough to find legends from Arkansas. So we have Ahmad Carroll, 93 overall. He was a first-round pick, selected number 25 overall in the 2004 NFL draft from the Green Bay Packers. He's a two-time first-team All-SEC. But most importantly, he was a 2012 Grey Cup champion up here in Canada with the Calgary Stampeders, I think, or the Toronto Argonauts, one of them. There's only fucking six teams up here, for God's sakes. So we gave him a 93 overall. Then number two, we have Martine Bercher. That is, I'm telling you right now, that is not a woman, supposedly. He was a defensive back. He was selected in the sixth round of the 1967 draft, played for the Falcons and Vikings, but he did his thing in college, where he was part of the 1964 National Championship Arkansas Razorbacks. He was a 1966 All-American, and he's a member of the Arkansas Sports Hall of Fame, so we gave him an 89 overall. And then we have Tevin Mitchell, I found on free agency. Yeah. Now 89, we gave you a nice little overall so we can have three corners here. And hope, for the love of God, win a couple games. The safeties are pretty good. Number one, Steve Atwater. Everyone should know who Steve Atwater is by now. Even if you just don't watch a lot of football, he's had a couple mutt cards. But Steve Atwater, you know, one of my favorite players that I've gone back and looked at because he was just, you know, pretty much done his career when I started getting into football. But, I mean, just look at his hit on Christian Okoye. He was just, I don't even know who I could even compare him to now, to relate to the kids of today. Kind of like, literally, I would actually describe him as like a more athletic Cam Chancellor. Like, he's that imposer guy, but I think where Cam Chancellor lacks in coverage and they kind of use Earl Thomas to compensate, Steve Atwater could do it all. One of the best safeties, and I don't think he's in the Hall of Fame right now, but he definitely will be in the Hall of Fame, I would say, in the next 3 years. He's a beast. And then at strong safety, we went with Kanoy Kennedy, who I got a Wikipedia page for him. He was a second-round pick in 2000 by the Denver Broncos. He's had a solid career, actually, in the NFL here. A couple sacks, a couple forced fumbles. I'm not really familiar with him, to be completely honest with you, even though he's playing since I've watched. But the fact that you were a pretty solid safety in the NFL, had some longevity, we gave you a 95 overall. And kicker and punter, just whoever was here. So I think we have Matt Bryant and Sam Koch. I know that's not how you pronounce it, but I'm going to always pronounce it that way. So let's sim here to the mid-season. Oh, Jesus Christ. Let's sim to the mid-season point. And for the love of God, like this roster here. Again, we started, the last video was, who's number 20? Was it Clemson? We did Clemson? That was the first video where we started giving everyone some kind of crazy overalls and making the overall team roster, you know, as good, if not slightly better, than the base legendary team rosters. And we still got shit pumped. Like, I think we went fucking 6-10, something stupid like that, 7-9. So hopefully, for the love of Arkansas, can start. I mean, this is not the strongest roster that we're going to do. Definitely not the weakest. But next video, though, for you guys that are wondering, is going to be the Michigan State Spartans. And this is looking like a very solid roster, to be completely honest with you. Definitely, on paper, looks like a stronger roster than Arkansas. So if things don't work out in our favor and we struggle to get a couple wins in this one, I think maybe Michigan State could be the team that sets the tempo for us, if you will. But that's a misleading thing about this series. People think like, oh man, by the time C4 gets all the way to like the top five, they're going to be really good. Not necessarily. Like, I'm looking at like, I don't really want to spoil, like it's not really a secret, but I don't want to spoil who I'm doing for like the top 10. But I'll say right now, that look at this, 2-6. 2-6, man. What is going on? Like, look, where are we weak? Quarterback's 87. Okay, maybe that's not the best, but we got 90s on wide receiver. Offensive line average overall is probably 93. What do we got on defensive side of the ball? 90, 90, 80, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90. 90s everywhere, and we're fucking 2-6. Like I said, I don't know. I honestly don't have an answer for you. It's not even just the rosters itself. Like, when I was doing the legendary roster series, I had teams that were weaker, for sure, than the team I'm using right now. We're getting to the playoffs. So, I don't fucking know, to be honest with you guys. My apologies for the fact that we're not winning much, and I hope you're still getting stuff out of this, seeing what my legendary rosters look like. And I'm getting 2 games in with them, but girlfriend's texting me. Jeez, leave me alone. So we're 3-7. I mean, we're definitely not making the playoffs here. Like, I don't know what the fuck to do. Do I just give everyone if I give everyone a 99, then if we lose, it's even more pathetic. But then if we win, it's just like, well, what's the fucking point? You just made everyone unrealistically a 99. I don't know. Maybe it's just luck of the draw. We're going to have, like, the fucking first 10 videos of this struggle to make the playoffs, and maybe things will look a little bit better on the other side. Remember, they know that I juiced some of these players, and like, this Ryan Mallett's not an 89 overall. We're going to make Ryan Mallett play as is, or something like that. I don't know. But as it stands right now, this series is pretty much mostly me talking about the roster and getting very little playing time with them. All right, so we play the Panthers and we play the Saints. It looks like we're going to finish probably 8-8, which is the fucking mold. But here we go. Every single time I forget to switch to the half-assed jersey attempts that I made for the college teams, but not today. Look at that. Horrible. Look, we made Georgia. That actually looks fucking dead on. That's like one of the best ones that we have. But for today, we have Arkansas, which I mean, ugh. The helmets are the biggest thing in this game. They don't have, like, this. Every helmet's pretty much black. And there's not a lot of black helmets I don't even know if I can think of one college right now that wears black that I'd be using this. I think Texas Tech's black. TCU's probably black, maybe. But, you know, fuck, why can't we win games? I want to know why. Like, it's not the dip. Like, it's just the same. It's just the way fucking things are going. Because I said I don't want to do this the way that I did the original Legendary Rosters, which where I played every divisional opponent, just because those videos were too fucking long. I don't want you guys to be held out too long. I just want you to get a quick taste, maybe learn a couple things about a college. I learned some things when I was making this. I don't know. I still don't know a whole lot about all these players. But I'd say it is increasing my football knowledge a teeny bit. But fuck me, let me win a couple games. That much to ask. I don't know what I can do. And like I said, I'm scheduling a bunch of these. Like, I'm recording this, and you guys are going to be seeing this at least 2 weeks after I recorded it. But I'm going to slow down a little bit because my ban from live streaming is eventually going to come up very soon. And I'm going to use these videos to, you know, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start my live streams up again once a week doing these college legendary rosters. So because those, I want to be a little bit longer. Oh, we hit Hunter Henry. I want those to be a little bit longer just because so I can talk with you guys in the chat. Maybe I can look at playing more divisional games or something like that. But for as is, man, I don't know. I don't even think, like, I can't even try to come up with reasons because it shouldn't be doing this. We have a good enough roster that we should for sure be competing for playoffs every year, not completing just to go to fucking 8-8. But we will. Maybe. We'll find out. We'll take a quick gander at the stats after the next week game, see how everyone did this season, and we'll see where everyone's at, what was going on, you know, what the fucking problem is. Right, we got Darren McFadden, run DMC to the outside. Horrible blocking. Stumbles in the back of his blocker, and a loss of, I don't know how much on that play. Maybe it's the kicker. Maybe that's our reason why. We've lost all our games by a field goal, because our goddamn Matt Bryant can't make a field goal to save his life. Oh, that's a good grab. Herndon, good grab. Let's go a little no huddle here. So I'm pretty sure that when Darren McFadden was at Arkansas, they ran Wildcat. Because it's one of those things that's been in Madden for a little bit of time. Fucking McFadden's always had, like, for some reason, like, low-key solid passing stats for a non-quarterback. And I knew he did a little bit, but I can't confirm or deny that they ran Wildcat. I think that might have been just, like, gimmicky. Occasionally run a little bit of Wildcat. But oh, we get destroyed. And that's a face mask on Luke Cuscielli. Remember that? That was hilarious. I remember that was the second year I started doing NFL draft videos, and I was like looking around to see what other people were doing. I was a small channel, so I was trying to see, like, this guy's getting way more views than me on this draft video. What's he doing that I'm not? And maybe I could see, like, where I can improve. And he was like, I remember I watched the first one. He was like, the top player in this year's draft is Luke Cuscielli. And I was like, oh, Jesus Christ. Some people shit on the way I say, what are they, like, the two names is Malik for Malik. And I think that might be the only one. That's the only one. That's the, because there's a couple players named, like Malik Jackson and Malik Hooker. That's how we say it up here in Canada. Jesus Christ, can't people understand? Nobody understands. So we're here at 7-7 ball game. Don't like this play at all. I know it's a screen, but we'll have Wright come out across the middle. Oh, the pump fake. And he finds him across the middle. Big catch by Jarius right across the middle of the field. Look at Ryan Mallett. 10 of 13, 116 yards. No turnovers. Can't do. Oh, we got the touchdown with the computer. Cool. 2-minute drill. Get some points. Well, I can tell by the, you know, the inability to stop the Panthers. Maybe our defense is what was doing us wrong here, but I find that hard to believe. We got Steve Atwater back there. Oh my God! What was that? What was that? Oh, that was not. That was mostly on me, but also definitely have seen much better play. They missed the field goal. Hey, look at that shit. All right. Yeah, that's why the game realized they kind of fucked me on that play a little bit and made them miss the 10-yard field goal. Jesus Christ. Offensive line is, like I say, struggling, but if injuries were on, Ryan Mallett would be on IR. A couple hits he's taken. Look at the Jets. 0-14 New York Jets. Jesus. Good God. Great googly moogly. Oh, Jesus Christ. Something like the CFL out here. So, yeah. Don't want to kind of move on to the next one. But I think Michigan State, for the love of God. Like, I knew the Clemson one for sure. If that didn't work out, I was going to be like, all right, this kind of messed up. That Clemson roster is really good. But then I saw that Arkansas was next. I was like, ooh, that might not be an automatic final. We're going to turn around and make the playoffs. But Michigan State, we got Le'Veon Bell, Kirk Cousins, guys like that. For sure, if we struggle to compete and we just battle to go fucking 8-8 with Michigan State, I'm going to say maybe this series is doomed. And not doomed from the fact that I'm not going to do it anymore, just doomed from the fact that maybe they're just not going to let me win. Maybe there's some algorithm in the game that sees that there's like, this guy had, like I said in the other video, this guy here has 20 guys from the same college. Maybe he's trying to do some sort of college video. And it's just those people that like hate when, fuck, third pick of the day from Ryan Mallett. And of course, Darren McFadden with 93 speed will not be able to catch that guy. Fuck's sakes. Maybe this game's algorithm, as well as making my point, has something to say like, you know, maybe this guy thinks he's some sort of smartass and thinks that a college football team can beat a pro team. So we're let's show him how easy it really is. Or something like that, I don't know. Maybe the game developer, while being a Charger fan, apparently, because Chargers just dominate in every one of these fucking sims, is also a Cleveland Brown fan, was sick and tired of hearing Alabama could beat the Cleveland Browns. Or Ohio State could beat the Cleveland Browns. Okay, well, it's disappointing. Like, I think I lost the two games that I played with Clemson. So, I'm 0-2. And then I'm about to go 0-3 playing. There we go, Lance Allsworth. Why don't we just throw it to Allsworth the whole time? Seemed to work pretty good for us. Four verts. So, yeah. I'm going to say that I'll probably go up to number 15 or number 14 before I start doing the live stream, by the way. So, this is 19. Yeah, damn it. Plus, I gotta start working on some rebuilds as I'm recording this. You guys have seen, like, this is just, maybe I'll give you an insight on how much I like to plan ahead. Today, as I'm recording this, in a couple hours, you're going to see the Saints rebuild, which I thought was a pretty solid one. So I have to get to recording on the next one. Throw the check down to Henry. Let him make, I'm even get a touchdown and make this game look a little bit more respectable. I gotta start working on the other one. I try to get on a good schedule of doing the upload, what do they call it? The fucking realistic rebuilds. That's forever. When I first started that series, literally, I was like, they come on Fridays, and I was like working so that, like, you guys were pretty much getting them after I edited them. Like, they were, I finished them Thursday night, and you were seeing them Friday. I don't like doing that. That makes this almost seem like a job. Like, I'm working for the fucking deadline to get this out. Roughly, I'd like to have all the rebuilds done, like, no later than Tuesday, Wednesday, so that I have a couple day buffer of... Rebuilds are fucking... Like, I know a lot of people, like, shit on other people that do rebuilds. Like, that's not a good rebuild. How do you drop that? But they take a lot of fucking time and effort to do. Just even from, like, an editing standpoint, not so much like trying to make the video entertaining and thinking of, like, ways you can... Like, what rookies you should get and stuff. Having to edit all the rookies and all that stuff on top of it. So... As someone, I just don't want to constantly be, like, having to feel like I have to work with a deadline. So, hopefully, like this weekend, I record the next rebuild. Oh, get out of bounds! We got no timeouts! Where was this Ryan Mallett a couple fucking plays ago? Oh, what a dart. What a dart to Hunter Henry. There we go. Dave Quinn is fucking loving it. Hallelujah. Four passing touchdowns on the day. Made it look a little bit more respectable, but still, we got our ass handed to us by the Carolina Panthers here. Maybe this is just, because I just still think that when I do my Eagles connected franchise moan, it's probably my favorite thing to do out of all this because it is playing with my Eagles. I win a lot, and I feel like a lot of people tune in. If you're not an Eagles fan, you're not super like invested in the Eagles winning to see if I lose the game. You're trying to see like, man, this guy dominates. The game is not really reflective of my. Like I'm playing on all Madden. Look at that. We are struggling to go 500 overall, 95, 99 offense, 99 defense. What the fuck else can I do, people? What the fuck else can I do? Speaking about the Eagles playing franchise mode, I feel like people watch to see if I lose, and I'm not. That game is not super reflective of how I play as a Madden. I think I'm a. If A plus is a fucking professional Madden player, I think I'm probably in a B plus category. Like I could beat most people if I played online. I don't play online because I fucking even though I'm a grown man, I struggle with my emotions when I play games like that. I just lose my shit. I don't make enough money on YouTube that I can go through a fucking controller every month. But the team's really good. That's why my Eagles team is exactly built the way I want to play. It's how. It should be. How a connected franchise mode that you want to personally enjoy should be built. I have the best playbook for me. I have the best roster for how I play my playstyle. So that's why we win a lot. We don't win them all. We haven't won the fucking Super Bowl yet. Hopefully we can win the Super Bowl before the next year's Madden comes out. But maybe that's why I win so much in that. And I win a decent amount in the expansion franchise mode that I'm doing. It's definitely a little bit more difficult. And the wins are much more difficult to achieve, but I'd say for the most part, I win more than I lose. So now maybe this is why. The game's like, oh, you're doing some one-off connected franchise mode, C4. Maybe fucking EA bugged my Xbox or something like that. I'm like, oh, here's a couple L's. Hold these L's here, buddy. But at least with the struggling of this, these videos aren't much more than half hour long, so you guys can carry on with your days. Now, hopefully you know a little bit more about the Arkansas Razorbacks football program, and you'll know that even though you have a 99 offense and a 99 defense, you'll still struggle to go 8-8 occasionally here in Madden. Why is Darren McFadden lined up a wide receiver? And hey, can I get shout out for being, this is the first time out of how many episodes that for both of the games I've used the jersey kind of that I was supposed to use. Every other time I just skip right past it and end up using not the jersey and not the reason why I decided to use that NFL team as the base team for a college team. So maybe shout out to me. For fucking all that route running. Oh. Go. Come on, we want the win. Lance Allworth with the big time reception. He got that Julian Edelman route running, baby. 59-yard touchdown. Let's go. Making Ryan Mallett's stat line look great there. Doing all the work. Alright, let's try to get the run here established a little bit. As the Saints turn the ball over, tisk, tisk. Oh, this is not even. I think the roster's somewhat saved. I don't know how I saved them, but this may be the Georgia Tech roster because we did use Saints for the team. I don't know. Maybe I can see up to the stats. If they still have Drew Brees as their quarterback, they won't know. But if they have Joe Hamilton or whatever the fuck I made, I'm still surprised. Out of all these teams that made the top 25, still very surprised that Georgia Tech was in and not like a Stanford or an Oregon or fucking what other teams weren't there. Definitely Stanford. I thought Stanford for sure would have showed up. Not Georgia Tech. All right, let's kick this field goal. Whoa. All right, 10-0 first quarter. Let's just do this. Let's make this a 40-0 game and get out of here. Check the stats and let you guys just carry on. All right, we're in the red zone. What else? Oh, I just talked about Darren McFadden. Remember how sick he was? Darren McFadden used to be, like, the cheesiest Madden guy in when he was a rookie. When he was back with the Raiders, he's always the guy that, like, you'd want to trade for because his awareness was the only reason why he sucked or his rating wasn't, like, high. Like, if you gave him, like, 85 awareness, his, like, 78, 79 would turn up to, like, a fucking 90. He always had, like, he was, like, always the best guy that was the combination of speed. You always have, like, 93, 94 speed, but also have, like, fucking, like, 88 trucking. Oh, I remember all the good old days. Now you got Ezekiel Elliott. Ugh. I remember the good old days when speed and trucking was all you needed for a running back. You didn't need a goddamn pass-catching, pretty much converted wide receiver to play. Oh, come on, X. Keep running, X. And we fumbled it. Jesus Christ, I'm throwing that one on X. It would have kept running to the corner of the end zone. That would have been a fucking touchdown. I disagree with that call there, wide receiver. I think that might have been Lance Allworth. Kick the field goal. God, luckily Matt Bryant's like a 90, so that was pretty easy. Nice slow pace. Oh, we're losing because we... What the fuck? Oh, yeah, I guess. Yeah. That was a little bit on me because I didn't know. I couldn't read the safety. I was looking for the tight end, Hunter Henry. A little bit on the game. Everyone knows when things aren't going your way, it's EA Sports. Blame it on the game, right? Isn't that their motto? So the check down, that was almost picked off. Oh, someone beat their man. No, goddamn, I need to win one of these fucking games. Maybe we could fit it into Lance Allworth. Oh, he tried. He tried. The road is long. Need some of that fucking. If I wouldn't get copyright claim. Oh my god. If I wasn't gonna get. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'd play like any of that song, that background music you see on like the Donate to the Starving Kids in Africa. You know, that's just how fucking depressing this is. It rhyme out just wonky. Like every time he throws it, even if he's like, look, he hasn't thrown a turnover yet. Fucking just a wonky throwing motion here. Looking like fucking Tim Tebow here. Up in this bitch. Oh, good grab. Good grab by Allworth. Why do I keep saying Allworth? James Allworth. Lance Allworth. Enunciate the L. There's no S. Well, I mean, this game's not technically over. We can somehow get the computer to kick an onside kick and recover it for us. Oh, good pancake block, 62. I think that was Sean Andrews. We'll get that one. There we go. Ooh, I can already tell that's the issue. 30 touchdown passes on the year for Mallett. Ooh. The fuck? Okay, we made the punt return for a touchdown. Look at this shit. We can win. All right. Let's go. Small victories. Potentially. Okay, can't put the carriage before the horse. Oh my god, why can't this guy make a catch? He's like an 87. He's dropped 3 passes already. We go back to the run, I guess. Oh, get that. You gotta. Oh my. Double stiff arm. Horrible blocking. And then fucking Derek Fad decides to fucking 2-time. Clap back that motherfucker. Let's watch that shit. That was a. Oh no. Okay, we're watching that. With very limited to be hype about, that was fucking awesome. Here we go. Horrible blocking by 78. Stiff arm the shit out of the guy. He comes back. Make sure you stiff arm him again. Oh, and he fumbled it. That would have been customary to how this video has gone so far. Make a great play and then have a guy fucking fumble it after all that. That was awesome, though. That's the first time I've seen that. And with a little beast quick stiff arm times 2. Oh, that's beauty. That is a beauty. Oh, my God. How are you not going to connect with that? Oh my fuck, how are you not gonna connect with that? He was wide open. Well, not wide open, but he beat his man. And that's all you're good at. At the end of the day, Ryan Mallett's 2 strongest attributes is his throw power and his deep throw accuracy. Oh, how are you not gonna fucking connect on that? Maybe try it again? There we go. Oh, come on, give me the victory. Give me the victory. What a drive. Jesus. It's like we're a 9-9 overall offense or something like that. That's what it felt like there. You do not let them get a touch. I hate this sim so much sometimes. Sometimes I hate this so much. I guess we try for it again. The safeties are definitely going to drop back off. Oh, let's go! Oh, there we go. Finally, something to get hype about that. What a fucking end. That was a great game. Are you kidding me? Where was that on the fucking Lance all? Well, I mean, it's water under the bridge. We connect the next time. Look at that. 0 seconds on the clock. Who's that? I don't even know who that is. But Jarius Wright. Oh, great. There you go. There you go. Finally. So, I mean, like, obviously, he did make the playoffs with a roster that was fucking 99 overall. But there you go. That's a little bit better resemblance of what kind of content you get here on Beast Mode TV. This is your first time stopping by. Don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button. But I'll remind you about that after we check out the stats. Oh, that was a good game. I need that. Sometimes when you do stuff like this and you just continue to lose, you don't get as motivated to do it anymore. I think I might go record the next one. I think I might record Michigan State right after this. I don't know yet. I get something to eat, you know? Maybe some fish. You like fish dicks? Love them. You're a gay fish? What? All right, let's take a look here at the stats as we went. What was our season record before we do that? 7-9, where the Bucks went 0-15. Jesus. Ryan Mallett, 40, we'll round out 4,500 passing yards, 32 touchdowns, and 16 picks. I'd say that's probably, I don't know, that's fringe of what you'd need a quarterback to get in the playoffs with these rosters. So, I mean, the 16 pick, I don't know. Running the ball, we have 1,200 yards and 12 touchdowns from Run DMC, 364 yards, 3 touchdowns from Niall Davis. Not horrible. Receiving, we got 82 receptions, 1,252 yards, 8 touchdowns from Lance Allworth. 741 and 3 from Jarius Wright, almost 800 and 7 from Hunter Henry, and almost 1,000 and 4 touchdowns from Javonte Herndon, 550 and 5 from Darren McFadden. So, I mean, that's probably a little bit off the mark of where you want, but not horrible. Now, the defense side of the ball, 123 tackles from Jerry Franklin. We got 106 from Ronnie Caveness. On the sack front, we got 10 from Trey Flowers, 5.5, 5. So definitely didn't get up to the quarterback nearly enough. Definitely. Come on, Dan Hampton. Only 2 sacks. On the interception front, we got 4 picks from Martine Bircher. 4 from Ahmad Carroll. 3 from Jerry Franklin. 2 from Kenoy Kennedy. 2 from Tevin Mitchell. 2 from Tony Bua. So, that does it here for this. I'm not exactly sure why we didn't make the playoffs, but that last game was pretty fucking epic, if I do say so myself. So hopefully you guys did enjoy that. And as always, if you're new to the channel, don't be afraid to hit that subscribe button. If you guys truly, truly did like this video, don't be afraid to hit that like button. I mean, guys, YouTube's telling me right now, I just got actually a call on my phone. It's a text, actually. It says, if you don't get at least 109 likes on this video, they're going to do something horrible to my cat. And he's already dead, so I don't know what the fuck they're going to do there. Rest in peace, Mike Snacks. R.I.P. Wow, this took a dark turn. I'm really upset right now. I don't want to talk about it. Thank you for watching. Until next time, guys. It's your boy C4 saying peace.